So here we have your worm farm.
Yeah, this is a worm farm.
Using an old bath.
I just have two sections, so I'm always feeding one section and letting the other section rest. Then I harvest the worm castings from this side while they're busily eating away at the other side.
How do you harvest the worm castings?
Most of the worms will migrate over into the section with food, but if they don't, I can come and take the top layer off.
Which is all worm castings.
Yeah, which is all worm castings. This at the moment is pretty much all worm castings. This is actually stuff that's come out of the aquaponics system, really.
I found one worm, but... What an invitation. The opportunity to check out a box full of maggots. Okay, what do we have here, JJ?
So this is a biopod, which we use to grow black soldier fly larvae. In it, we throw a lot of the smelly stuff that you might not usually put in your compost. I'll open it right up. We throw fish guts, fish heads, chicken bones. It does get a little bit smelly. Flies come along, they go into the system, they lay their eggs, those eggs turn into maggots. And then they harvest themselves mostly to go to their next stage of development. They need to try and find some soil.
Yes.
So they climb up out of here and they're looking to go and find a nice piece of soil to grow in. But this little bucket catches them and they fall into here. So these are my little European honeybees. Both are a little bit different to each other. I was going to say I farm them, which is probably true. I farm them in a slightly different way to other people, in that this is worry beekeeping, where there's no queen separator. The bees really just have the run of the hive like they would do in nature. There's no foundation wax for them to lay on. They just start at the top and basically build their comb downwards. And when I want to harvest, I take from the top and I put a new box at the bottom.
So how much honey a year are you collecting?
Last year, from this box alone, we had 60 kilos.
60 kilos from one hive?
Yeah.
You are kidding.
No, and that was its first season. The bees and fish are probably the two most popular things that the woofers really enjoy. We want fish for dinner tonight.
Kyle and Brian are woofers, and as such, they do a range of jobs. Today, they're learning how to harvest fish. They're going to use clove oil, which sedates and calms the fish, and then they're going to give the fish their one bad day. But I put the cart before the horse. Of course, you can't do anything with the fish if you haven't caught any. So here they are. They're going to be using barbless hooks, and they're going to have a go. If they catch a fish that they don't want, they can release it without any real damage. They don't release it back into the main pond area. They put it into a special area because they don't want that fish passing on any knowledge. Believe it or not, fish are intelligent.
Oh, it's a big one, don't lose him. Quick, get him over to the side. Yeah, that's it. Wow, he's a good one. Oh, Brian's got one too. Do you want to put him in? Yeah, put them in the pink bucket. No, you see, they'll kind of slow down in there and they just get a bit sleepy.
There is one huge silver perch in this pond. For me, it's Moby Dick.
Whoa. Must have been that big guy again.
It's true. The big one got away. Fishing can be really frustrating. Sometimes you get a really big fish, but if it's too big, it gets off the hook or it breaks the line. They've tried a couple of times to get it, and then, in fact, they got it on their hook and it got away.
Now he's going to be the hippest fish in the pond.
Yeah, he sure is.
Yeah. Now he'll want a tat.
This fish must have nine lives. It's not a cat. I'm sure I saw it's got scales. It's a fish. I've seen this one escape twice in the last 15 minutes. JJ's completely over this. Suggested to the woofers, get the net. I think they've got it. There it is, Moby Dick. They've got Moby Dick. Well, they've caught the fish. And this is the hardest part of the whole process. The fish has to be dispatched. Fortunately, the clove oil makes it a painless procedure.
Need a bigger bucket for that guy.
Well, now it's dead. It's got to be gutted. We were very lucky to see them fishing today. Obviously, this doesn't happen all the time. Fishing is a lot of fun. I'm not sure this is really sporting, but the fish had a good life, and it brings to the conclusion this whole life cycle of little fingerlings in the pool, growing, being eaten. I've heard talk about productive ponds. I've seen people think, yeah, I want a productive pond. This is the result of a productive pond. It's not fish in a cage, it's actually fish on the plate. So a chlorinated swimming pool, it was changed from this pool to a pond, using the nutrient-rich water from the fish to feed the plants. And now, a chlorinated pool that was of no use to anyone has all of a sudden become a means of setting itself up for a sustainable future. These fish were in this pond, they've been smoked, now they're about to be eaten.